Hi, Namaste children. Welcome back to our social studies class. Children, in my previous video, I had explained to you about your 12th lesson, that is our local bodies. In that lesson, we discussed about panchayat, it means village panchayat or grama panchayat, and how it forms. After that, what are the duties of grama panchayat or village panchayat? And also the head of the panchayat is called what? And about panch, panch means they are the members of panchayat, village panchayat, that we discussed. And later we discussed about municipal committees and municipal councils, and the heads of the municipal councils and committees, and members of the municipal committees are called as councillors, that we discussed. Then what are the duties of municipal committees? So, and they, where they work. About these all the things we discussed in our previous videos. Now I am going to discuss with you the exercise part of your 12th lesson, our local bodies. Please look at your screen. I am going to share those all the question answers on your screen now. If you have textbook, you can open it and sit. Please look at your screen now. Yes, look at this children. Panchayat. Panchayat is nothing but word power in that, you see. A body of 5 elected representatives from the local population or local people, it is called as panchayat. 5 members, 5 is nothing but pancha, pancha means 5, 5 janaru irthakanta, 5 jana sadasyaru irthakanta ondu tanda athwa organization, it is panchayat. And next one is mayor. Mayor means head of the municipal corporation. Head of the municipal corporation is called mayor. Municipal corporations will be in the cities, big cities we have their municipal corporations. Then next one, tax. Tax is nothing but an amount of money that one has to pay to the government. It means tax on our land, tax on our sites, tax on our farm, tax on our buildings, tax on our electricity, tax on water supply and all. Taxes we are paying to the government, no? Those are all taxes. Money we are paying to the government, it is tax. And let us recall what are all the things we discussed. People of 18 years or more than that, they are going to put the vote and elect the municipal committee members and village panchayat members. It means if you are crossed 18 years of age, then you are getting the voting power. Then after that, the local body that makes care, that takes care of the needs of the people living in the cities and the municipal committees. So where people are living, those people's care will be taken by the municipal committees and the village panchayats. Next, the local body or local government takes care of the needs of the people, which are they who are all living in that village. And later, to take care of the needs of people, our country, we have elected local bodies. It means to take care of the local people's needs, we are going to put the vote and elect the members of the local bodies. These are all the things we discussed already in our previous class. Now, exercise part. Tick the correct answers in that first one. The head of the municipal corporation is called, what we call him? Councillor, mayor, deputy mayor. So the head of the municipal corporation is called mayor, M-A-Y-O-R, M-A-Y-O-R, mayor. Mayor is called as head of the municipal corporation. Second one, in big cities we have dash municipal committees, municipal corporations, parliament. Parliament will be in the national level, so it is not. Municipal committees will be in the towns, small cities, there we have municipal committees. But in big cities, we have their municipal corporations. Option, second option is correct for this. Municipal corporations will be in the big cities, second option. Third one, the head of a panchayat is called dash. Head of the panchayat is called what? Sarpanch, then Prabhandak or Gram Sevak. Correct answer is Sarpanch. Third one, option first is the correct. Sarpanch. The head of a panchayat is called sarpanch. Next children, fill in the blanks are there. The members of a village panchayat elect their dash. What they elect? Can you guess? They elect their members. Then second one. The village panchayat or panchs also you can call them. Elect their members or the panchs. Panchs means they are the members only. Members are called as panchs also. Panch also you can write. Panchs. Second one. The village panchayat runs and keeps the village. What it keeps? Think and tell in the lesson I told, no? Can you? Yes, correct answer. You can write here clean. The village panchayat runs and keeps the village clean also you can write. Or then you can write healthy also you can write. H-E-A-L-T-H-Y. Healthy also you can write. Any one option to be written here. So the panchayat of the village, it runs the village and also it keep the village, it keeps the village clean or healthy or some other things you can write. So it keeps the village properly or neatly. That all the things, those all the things you can write here. Third one, men and women who are dash years of age or above can elect a municipal committee. It means those who are getting that opportunity to put the vote, they must be 18 years or more than 18 years. So 18 you can write here. Okay, third one, 18 years. And fourth one, municipal committee gets money from tax on dash and dash. On what it is going to get the money? Can you guess? So water supply and electricity, and those two things you can write. Or you can write on land. On land also you can write, and also you can write houses. Any two things you can write here. So municipal committee, it is collecting the taxes on houses and land. It is one option. Or second option also it is there for you. Electricity and water supply. And these two also, they are collecting the tax. Any two you can write here. Okay, next one. Seamen. Write T for the true and F for the false statements it is given. So if they are true means you have to write their T. If they are wrong means you have to write their F. It means false. First one, the village panchayat is not an elected body. It means people of the village are not going to put vote and elect them. Is it correct or wrong? It is wrong. It is false. So it means they are going to put vote and elect their members. But they given here, it is not an elected body. It is not an elected body. So it is false. So you write F for the first one. F, first one is false. Second one, the village panchayat settles disputes between villagers. What are disputes? Disputes are nothing but they are the problems. They are the problems. Problems between the villagers, it is disputes we call them. Okay, so it means panchayat's duty, it is the panchayat's duty to solve the problems between the villagers. Yes, it is true. First one is T. Second one is T. First one false, second one true. Third one, the municipal committee gets money by selling land. It means municipal committee is going to sell the land and get its money for the works. No, it is false. Municipal committee, it is not selling the land. It is going to collect its money by taxes. Putting taxes on the people, on their land, on their houses, on electricity supply, on water supply, on these things, it is going to put to tax and get money. So third one is false. F can be written here. Fourth one, the panchayat appoints a grama sevak or sevika. It means panchayat is going to appoint the people, those who are the workers in the panchayat. Water supplying department, in that workers will be there. Cleaning department, in that workers will be there. Sweepers. Sweepers will be there, no? So they are all called as grama sevaks and sevikas. Man means grama sevaka. Woman means sevika. Okay. Man, sevak. Women, sevikas we call them. Okay, sevikas we call them. So keep it in your mind. It means they are appointed by panchayat. Yes, it is true. Now recently, now our government has changed this rule. Panchayat, now it is not having that right to appoint the workers in the workers of the panchayat. So now it will be under the DC. Now recently they changed this rule. Earlier panchayat only it was appointing the workers, but now onwards DC of that particular district or respective district is going to appoint the panchayat workers. So now that work is given to the DC of the district. So once again I am repeating them. First one is false, second one is true, third one is false, fourth one is true. Next one, D option or D main, answer these questions. First one, who elects a village panchayat? So answers for this, see here. The villagers who are 18 years of age and above elects a village panchayat. Okay, it means those who are crossed 18 years and those who are reached 18 years, they are going to put vote and elect their members or elect the panchayat. So that is why answer for this question is this. Now, second one, what are the functions of the village panchayat? What are the duties of the panchayat? Why we want panchayat? Answer is here. The functions of the village panchayat are: A, it works to keep the village clean. Second, B, it arranges drinking water for people and electricity for roads and street lights at night. These are all the things will be done by the panchayat. Next, C, it also helps to run the hospitals and controls diseases in the village. These are all the duties of village panchayat or gram panchayat. Third one, what does a municipal committee do? It means what are the duties of municipal committee? Now recently we discussed about functions or duties of village panchayat. Now municipal committees will be in the towns, small cities. What are their duties? They given here, the duties of a municipal committee are: A, it makes arrangements for the cleanliness of the city. Okay, it means it is going to keep the city clean. It is the duty of that municipal committee. B, second one, it makes arrangements for lighting on the roads and street at night. Streets will be there, no? Areas, in the different areas there will be street lights, whether they are working or not, to check them. If they are not working, making repair, these are all the duties of municipal committee. And last one, it supplies drinking water to all the people and runs primary schools for children. It means it supplies drinking water for all the people of the city, and also it is going to run the school for the children of the city. So these are all the duties of municipal committee. Next, fourth one, from where does a municipal committee get money? So it is going to get money, it is doing these all the works, no? There will be so many workers working in the municipal committee, no? Workers, laborers. For them, how it gives money? So it is going to collect taxes. How? Answer, you see, the municipal committee gets its money by tax on land and houses, tax on water supply and electricity, and tax on the use of roads. We are paying tax or toll amount to the ruling authority, which will be there in that area. For that ruling authority, we are going to pay the tax amount or road tax. So that money will be going to the municipal committee. It means why it is collecting that money? To give salary to its workers, and it is using that money to do the developmental works in the city. For these all the purposes, it is going to collect the taxes, and it is going to get the money from these taxes. Last question, do you help in keeping your home and school clean? Do you help your somebody will be, for example, IAS in our school, they will be cleaning and keeping our school clean. Do you help them? Yes, we must help them. In our home also, we need to help our mother to keep our home clean while sweeping or wiping our floor. That time we need to help them a little. So it is our duty to help them. Then how we are going to help, like that they asked here. Yes, Answer is yes, I help in keeping my home and school clean through these following ways. Now I given some of the points here. You can write your own answers also for this question. Okay, if you want to write your own answers, you think and write, no problem for me. I am not telling you to write these answers only in your CW. Okay, you can write your own answers also. Option A, in that I will not throw any waste here and there. It means papers. After cutting the papers, throwing inside the class, it is not good. After sharpening the pencil, we are throwing that waste here only. It is not good. We need to take them and keep in the dustbin, whether in the school or at home, wherever you may be. So keep your home and school clean, your surrounding clean. That one. Second, I will pick the garbage and keep in the dustbin. Waste, garbage is nothing but waste things, papers, covers and other things, water bottles, okay, not metal one, other water bottles will be there, no, plastic water bottles and all. After using them, we are throwing here and there, juice bottles we are throwing here and there. After eating chocolates, we throw covers here and there. It is not good. We need to search for the dustbin and we need to put them in the dustbin only. We should not throw here and there. We are all educated children. So that we should not throw here and there. We need to help our parents and workers. Last one, I help my mother to keep the things in order. It means at home, throwing bags, throwing shoes after going to the home from school. Just you will go to home and you will throw your bag somewhere, you will throw your shoes somewhere, you will throw your socks somewhere, and you will go for the playing and other things. It is not good. We need to help our mother. From morning to till night, they will be working, keep on working for mother. So that we need to help her a little. We need to keep our bags in the correct place. We need to leave our shoes in the correct place. We need to keep our socks in the correct place. And we need, like this way, we need to help our parents a little. Little help can be done more. So that is why we need to help in keeping our home and school clean. So these are all the things I discussed with you today. In my next class, I am going to start your next lesson. Till then, take care, children. Bye.